Hey everyone, it's Liam from AdButler again, and today I'm going to go over the basics of our targeting, focusing on geographic and platform targeting today. This is one of two videos I'm going to be doing on our targeting. The second video will cover keyword targeting and a couple use cases and go really in depth on certain situations. Keyword targeting and platform geographic targeting work differently, which is why I'm splitting this video up. Targeting is a part of the assignment page, so if you aren't familiar with it and its settings, such as weighting, I'd recommend you head over to our video on it, linked right now, to get yourself familiar with it. Okay, so to start, let's head over to our targets dashboard. Here is where we create our preset geographic or platform targets so we can reuse them over and over. By geographic targets, I mean where someone is physically located based on their IP when they see the banner. And by platform target, we mean the kind of device they are viewing the ad on. Moving into geographic targets, we get a currently empty list that would display all of our preset geographic targets. We can click Add New to create one, and instantly you can see just how specific we can get in AdButler. We name the target, set its radius, although generally you can leave this alone, and set whether this is an inclusive target, we want to target things inside of it, or exclusive, we want to target outside of it. And then you use our really quick interface to get however specific you want, if it's city or province or country or whatever. All you need to do is check the box beside the location or locations, and as you can see, our locations are displayed via tree menu. This allows you to either select a branch of that tree or to select the entire tree. You can also select multiple locations at once, so if you want to grab part of a province or a few different provinces, that works too. For today, I'm just going to target AdButler's headquarters of Victoria, BC, Canada. It's a simple one, just like the town, but I like it. Now I click Save and you can see it in our geographic targets list. Creating a platform target is pretty similar. Select it on the left, once again being greeted by an empty list, and then click Add New to go into the Creation menu. As before, we give a name, and then we decide who we want to target. We have a few preset options, like mobile and desktop, but you can get right down to even specific devices if you have that device's specific pattern. Let's create a target for Internet Explorer customers on Windows computers. We can do that really easily by clicking Internet Explorer under Browser and Windows under Operating System. Click Save and we're brought right back to the previous screen and we can see our platform target is now listed. So, what do we do with these? Going to the assignment page for a banner or campaign, at the very bottom of the page is the targeting system. The platform and geographic dropdowns are right here and, look at that, our two targets have shown up. Just click them from the dropdown to select them and you can have both active at once. We also have a quick option to make a platform target if you haven't set one up before. Now if we hit Save, our banner campaign has targeting, and you can see that by the display right here. Perfect. So that is a really quick overview of geographic and platform targeting, a very quick interface that allows you to target multiple criteria and make that targeting net as big as you want it. I hope this video has been helpful, and keep an eye out for our other video on keyword targeting, which, I'm not kidding, is pretty magical in just how powerful it is. Let us know if this video helped at all by commenting or sending us an email, or if I missed anything. Also, if you are looking for videos on anything specific, leave a comment and or email us your suggestion and we'll get back to you. As always, Liam from AdButler here. Thanks for watching and have a good day.